हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, गुड मॉर्निंग टू वन एंड ऑल। आई एम डॉक्टर ये एन ये। दिस इज आवर सेकेंड क्लास। यस्टरडे वी सॉ द बेसिक इंट्रोडक्शन टू फोटोकेमिकल रिएक्शंस। फोटोकेमिस्ट्री इज द स्टडी ऑफ द इंटरैक्शन ऑफ लाइट एंड केमिकल्स। Organic photochemistry is a branch of organic chemistry that studies light induced chemical reaction of organic compounds. I repeat once again, organic photochemistry is a branch of organic chemistry that studies light induced chemical reactions of organic compound. So in this chapter, photochemistry of ketones, photooxygenation, photoreduction, photocycloaddition, Patanobuchi reaction, dipi methane rearrangement, cis trans isomerization, Burton reaction, photofrize reaction, photochemistry of cyclohexadienones synthesis of vitamin D. In general, the laws of photochemistry, the first one is Grothers-Draper law. The first law of photochemistry, known as the Grothers-Draper law, it states that light must be absorbed by a chemical substance in order for a photochemical reaction to take place. Only the light which is absorbed by a system can cause chemical change. This law was modified by Stork and Einstein. The Stork-Einstein law states that for each photon of light absorbed by a chemical system, only one molecule is activated for photochemical reaction. I repeat once again, this law was modified by Stork and Einstein. The Stork-Einstein law states that for each photon of light absorbed by a chemical system, only one molecule is activated for photochemical reaction. This is also known as the photoequivalent law, or that is only one excited molecule per photon absorbed. The Stork-Einstein law: one quantum of light is absorbed per molecule of absorbing and reacting substance that disappears. Molecules which absorb photons become physically excited. Note this point. Molecules which absorbs photons become physically excited, and this is must be distinguished from becoming chemically active. Quantum efficiency is, what will happen? The quantum efficiency is number of molecules decomposed or formed. Number of quanta absorbed. This is the quantum yield. That is, pi is denoted by number of molecules reacting or formed. Two things are there: number of molecule decomposed or forming, or by number of quanta absorbed in unit time. If each quantum of light is absorbed leads to the formation of product molecule. The pi, the quantum of yield will be 1. But in practice, it is usually less than 1 due to decay of same light energy by fluorescein, phosphorescence of radiational process. In the case of acetone, if example acetone absorb light to give an excited state from N to pi star transition, which can be either a singlet or triplet state, it has shown that from the triplet states, the carbon-carbon bond, generally the one alpha to the keto group C double bond O, being weaker as compared to carbon-oxygen double bond, breaks carbon-oxygen double bond. C double bond O breaks. So it is not possible to draw an explicit structure for the excited state. So photochemical reactions of ketones and aldehydes of carbon-carbon bond adjacent to carbon group and elimination of carbon monoxide are termed in the other reactions. Whereas the energy of electromagnetic photon in the visible UV region expressed in different units, regions given ultraviolet, that is violet, blue color, green, yellow, orange, red. Approximately wavelength in nanometer is given from 200 to around 750 in the increasing order. At the same time, the wave number in centimeter inverse and the energy mole inverse kilocalories and electron volt is also given, going on in the decreasing order. Interaction between light and molecule. Interaction between light and molecule. Photochemical reaction occurs by absorption of electromagnetic radiation to produce electronically excited states. It is the electronically excited molecules which gives the products of reactions. The process at rising molecules from ground state of minimum energy to an excited state of higher energy is called excitation. I repeat once again, students, please point to be noted. The process at rising molecules from ground state of minimum energy to an excited state of higher energy level of higher energy is called excitation. Excitation in the rotational, vibrational or electronic energy levels of molecules results from absorption in microwave. Remember this point once again, I repeat, listen carefully. Excitation in the rotational, vibrational or electronic energy levels of molecules results from absorption in microwave, infrared and UV region of the electromagnetic spectrum. Wave nature of radiation. मैक्सवेल थियरी ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक रेडिएशन लाइट ट्रैवल्स इन स्पेस इन द फॉर्म ऑफ ऑसिलेटिंग इलेक्ट्रिक एंड प्रोपोगेटेड इन स्पेस. लुक एट दिस पिक्चर, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. सो हाउ दी लाइट वेव्स गोइंग ऑन फ्रॉम अप एंड डाउन, दिस इज माइक्रोवेव. एनर्जी लेवल्स फॉर द इलेक्ट्रॉन कॉन्फिगरेशन फ्रॉम द वेरियस लेवल्स इंटर सिस्टम क्रॉसिंग. वंस फॉर्म द वेरियस स्टेट्स विल ईदर अंडरगो केमिकल रिएक्शन, दैट इज फोटोकेमिकल रिएक्शन, or lose their excitation by either a radiative or a non-radiative process. The molecules in the excited states can also lose its energy by intermolecular energy transfer. In organic molecules, almost all organic molecules in ground states or in singlet states with all electron spin paired with the various levels psi 1, psi 2, psi 3. In that case, the first excited state on absorption of light is usually a singlet state S1. It has already been stated that promotion from S0, that is ground state, to the excited state. This is the potential energy curve for a diatomic molecule. Formation of molecular orbitals from atomic orbitals. From 1s, 1s, formation of bonding, and similarly, how the antibonding 1s and another 1s, it shows clearly in the black circle. Similarly, for various levels, according to Pauli's exclusion principle, when two electrons are accommodated in the same orbital, their spins must be opposite. They are paired. I repeat once again. According to Pauli's exclusion principle, when two electrons are accommodated in the same orbital, their spins must be opposite, that is, they are paired. A molecule is said to be the singlet state, simply we called as S. If all the electrons in it are paired, according to Hund's rule, when the two electrons are assigned to different orbitals, the lowest energy, the lowest energy state will be the one in which these two electrons have parallel spins or unpaired. A molecule in which the two electrons are unpaired in a triplet state, simply we denoted as T. In an organic molecule, there are generally even number of electrons which are usually paired in the ground state, that is S0. Simply we for Yes, for singlet. So here ground state is zero. Ground state. So, okay. Don't assume it as yes. Yes. Zero. When the organic molecule absorbs light of appropriate energy, there is no spin inversion, and so the spin remain paired in the excited state. Now this is energy levels and type of transition in formaldehyde molecules. Just now I discuss the excited state in which there is no spin inversion is called excited singlet state. So in organic molecules, the electrician, these are in organic molecules, the most interesting type of electronic excitation are the N2 pi star and pi 2 pi star. The relative energies of sigma, pi and N, that is molecular orbitals, when excitation take place from one of the filled orbitals, sigma, pi or N gets excited to one of the vacant anti bonding orbitals, that is sigma star and pi star. The overlapping of two atomic orbitals produce two molecular orbitals. One of them is a low energy E1 orbitals, referred as bonding orbitals, and molecules both the electrons in the ground state of the molecules. Now come to the singlet and triplet levels. In organic molecules, there are generally even number of electrons which are usually paired in the ground state. So here S0. When the organic molecules absorb light of appropriate energy, there is no spin inversion, and so the spin remain paired in the excited state. This excited state in which there are no spin inversion called excited singlet state, S1. S1. Similarly, in many ways, however, the electronic excitation is followed by spin inversion, giving rise to new excited triplet state, that is T1. I repeat once again. In an organic molecule, there are generally even number of electrons which are usually paired in the ground state. S0. When the organic molecules absorb light of appropriate energy, there is no spin inversion, and so the spin remain paired in the excited state. The excited state in which there is no spin inversion is called excited singlet state, that is S1. In many cases, however, electronic excitation is followed by spin inversion, giving rise to new excited triplet state, that is T1. Direct excitation of the ground state S0 to a triplet state is not possible. The process can be visualized for the molecule. For example, that is ethylene molecule, in which absorption of light of appropriate wavelength promotes one of the pi electrons to the antibonding orbital pi star. It is bonding, pi bonding, and pi star is the antibonding. Next, come to the electronic, vibrational, and rotational energies. In that case, excuse me, now next we pass on to difference between photochemical and thermal reactions. On the basis of what has been stated so far, it can be said that thermal reactions occur through higher vibrational levels of the ground state, whereas photochemical reactions takes place through electronic excited states, singlet or triplet. I repeat once again, the difference between photochemical and thermal reactions. On the basis of thermal reaction occur through higher vibrational levels of the ground state, whereas photochemical reaction takes place through electronic excited state, singlet or triplet. Thermal reaction require less energy compared to photochemical reactions. Remember this point, very important question, point to be noted. Thermal reaction require less energy while compared to less energy when compared to photochemical reactions. So light induced or photochemical reactions are comparatively high energy process. In photochemical reaction, the light energy is absorbed by the reactant at room temperature or even below room temperature. So what is room temperature now? You know very well. Around 26, 28. Okay. So in photochemical reaction, the light energy is absorbed with the reactants. At room temperature or even below room temperature. In case photochemical reaction lead to polymeric products due to high concentration of substrate, in such case low concentration of substrate is used. So remember that the difference between photochemical and thermal. I repeat once again, thermal reaction occur through higher vibrational levels of the ground state, whereas photochemical reactions take place through electronic excited state, whether singlet or triplet. Thermal reaction require less energy compared to photochemical reactions. So light induced or photochemical reactions are comparatively high energy process. In photochemical reactions, the light energy is absorbed by the reactant at room temperature or below room temperature is enough. Whereas in the case of photochemical reaction lead to polymeric products due to high concentration of substrate. In such case, low concentration of substrate is used. With this, I conclude. Today's class. If you have any doubt, please contact personally or through mail or through Google Class. So I think you feel little bit dry, but anyhow, slowly you will learn. For that, the materials will be post in your Google Class. Thank you.